All right, Basement Gourmet. We're going to do a crawfish and shrimp gumbo today. Start off, we'll fire up a good-sized pan there. About a 3/4 cup of vegetable oil. Let that heat up. The oil's getting hot. We've got a 1 pound of Andouille sauces we're going to put in there. Brown that up. Let's get browning up there. Alright, that's browned up pretty good. We'll get that on some paper towels here. Now we got 8 ounces of pork Tasso. Brown that up. Pork Tasso. Andouille sausage. Right out there. Good stuff. Alright, I got that Tasso browned up pretty good. Same thing. Got all some towels here. Alright, now we got about a 3/4 cup of all-purpose flour. Make our roux. We have to add a little more oil here. Want this roux kind of on the thinner side. We're going to take about 20 to 30 minutes to get this roux to the color we want. Good dark. Almost burnt.
Want a little more oil maybe?
Another eighth of a cup maybe. The thing is now you don't want to let it go unattended for too long. Keep stirring. About the 10 minute mark. Still got ways to go. Keep working it. Scrape the bottom of the pan, make sure it's not all got a lot of black there. That's gonna be all kinds of flavor. I got another 15 minutes to go. Alright, getting closer. To the point now where it's done right or burnt. So keep an eye on it. Getting close. This stuff pretty dark though. It's about as close as you can get to burn without burning. We're getting there. Another 5 minutes, Brian. All right, it's been about 30 minutes. That's what we're looking for right there. Dark. You gotta be careful at this point. Burn it out. Game over. That's good. That's good dark. You don't want to go much darker, we're going to burn it. Alright, so what we're going to do, throw in our onion. Celery. Bell pepper. Good old faithful. Got beds all in that roux. I'll let that sweat a little. I think that's been going a few minutes. Garlic. Couple bay leaves. Three bay leaves. throw in some chicken stock. Probably 2 boxes, 8 cups. We're gonna get all that sausage, Tasso back in there. Give that a stir, bring that up to a slow boil and start skimming the scum off the top. A little bit of cayenne pepper. Go ahead and throw some tomatoes here. Some of these ultra cachitas. Don't always put tomatoes in my gumbo. Gumbo's one of them things where you put whatever you want it. I got a can of these sitting around, so I might as well throw a few of them in there. Maybe about half a dozen. About a quarter can. A little bit of that juice. And the tomatoes. Not too much. Alright, so she gets to a boil. So I get all this got the foam and scum starts coming to the top. Start skimming. Back the heat off now, just bring it down to the slow boil. I let it go for about an hour or so. We'll have the seafood. Seafood doesn't take long to cook, so we don't want to put it in now. We want this gumbo to cook long enough so we can get all the oil and all the scum at the top. You don't want a greasy gumbo. All right, so that's looking pretty good for the first skim. Give it a stir. Break up those tomatoes a little, maybe. Let her go, and we'll keep coming back. Skimming the scum. May have to add a little water. Going about a half hour now, and you can see the amount of scum that comes at the top is a lot less. And all that stuff, all that grease from that sausage. Skin of the scum. Alright, she's been going about an hour and a half maybe. You can see we're getting very little stuff at the top in between skimmings. So that's good. It's mostly the oil and grease from the sausages gone. And what we're gonna do? Got a pound of raw shrimp. All right, I'll add a pound of these crawfish tails straight from Louisiana. Good stuff here. Dump that in there. Oh, make sure we get all that juice out of there. So we don't go much more after this, maybe another half hour. Gonna bring her back up. There'll be a little foam and scum that comes off the seafood. We're pretty close at this point. Another half hour or so. So we got a little foam and scum that come off that seafood. Skim that off. Got some gumbo. Feel like that one. This is good stuff for gumbo. So ground sassafras leaves. Look at this. Actually. A little bit of that in there. Alright, so we're gonna get some of that gumbo. Oh, that's looking good. Get some rice back here. There you have it. crawfish and shrimp gumbo. Thebasementgourmet.
I'm going to taste this gumbo. Tell you what, some green onions on top. The top are off nice. Don't have it. Some crawfish, sausage, rice. Thank you.